money today, people do not care if he have cocoa bear. If a man have money today, people do not care if he have cocoa bear. He can commit murder and get a free and live in the governor's company. But if you are poor, the people tell you shoe and a dog is better than you.
Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of all the younger Calypsonians like myself of Trinidad and Tobago, I would like to thank Growling Tiger today for giving me and being responsible for putting forward what I believe in right now and what I love to do, and being one of the people who fought for the culture and fought for Calypso. And I hope that he will live to see it go on for many more years. To the Growling Tiger, thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, I am proud to be here this evening. It's a remarkable time for me. I started Calypso in San Fernando in 1934 at the Palace Cinema. I remain in San Fernando and become the first bantamweight champion of Trinidad and Tobago. From San Fernando, I went again and achieved the best, as did Calypso King of Trinidad and Tobago. I went to Grenada, I went to Barbados. Mr. Morris organized the West Indian Calypso competition. I won it there. They advertised me for the Marara in 1943. I won it there. I come back to San Fernando to you blind. And receiving the biggest monetary award that I ever received in my 76 years of life.
When we talk about Calypso in the early days, 1930s to 1950s, a lot of old names come to our minds. We think of Calypsonians like Attila the Hun, Pretender, the Roaring Lion. But one of the names which stand out in that golden era is the name of the Growling Tiger, Mr. Neville Marcano. And tonight, Calypso Showcase is pleased to meet in person this great personality. Neville Marcano, the Growling Tiger. Where were you born?
I was born in Digo Martin.
And then you grew up later on in Separia?
Yes, and San Fernando.
When did you move to Separia?
As a boy, very little boy. Couldn't even tell you that age. Let alone with imagining how small I was. Baby.
I read where you actually were a boxer before you became a Calypsonian. Is that true?
Yes, I won the championship. I knocked out Kid Ram for the bantamweight championship at Trinidad and Tobago in 1928.
You knocked out a guy called Kid Ram, eh?
Yeah.
And you were called the Separia Tiger.
Yeah, that's where I learned about, that's where I began boxing. It came as a blaze of wind from the corner. Two-fisted attack. Bantam, bantam, bright. I laugh and watching him, just so. And he hit across the right. He staggered, followed him up and across another right and hook him. He dropped. I see him bleeding from nose and eyes. I see he finished. He go down and take out two, three strangler shot. Uppercut him and that was it. Fight finished.
So that eventually led to your becoming the flyweight champion of Trinidad and Tobago.
Exactly. Bantamweight champion. Bantamweight.
But what got you into Calypso eventually?
Well, I never loved it. My aunt used to sing Calypso at Oropush Road. There was a tent there. She used to go and sing there. I go and listen to her time. Her name was Delayed. Personal name were Georgiana Joseph. I heard us singing there. There was a time when the killer man named Preto, and the case tried in Port of Spain, and they were exonerated. So I heard her singing there that night. I heard her asking who killed Preto. I heard her asking who killed Preto. They apprehended the murderers and let them go. Now they want us to tell them who killed Preto. I heard she sing that. I met Beginner and Mamin at San Fernando. They were living down at the corner of Lord Street and Mokorapo Street. He used to play a guitar. I went there, listened to him, and then he became this guy. I know him as a Calypsonian. He's singing and playing the guitar. But he don't only sing calypsos. He sing ballad song, you know, other songs and so forth, which I like. So I come from my mother, and I'll go there when she gone to work and listen to him playing the guitar all the time. Then when the Calypsonian come from Port of Spain, a tiller, lion, an executor, and these people, modern inventor, Trafalgar, and all these people, he would take part in the Calypso theater. I never went because I wasn't too anxious about it. As far as my grandmother was concerned, it's taboo. So I stay along. Sometimes I pass by him and he's composing. One day while I was there, a man came in, had one eye, and talked to him a great deal, and the man leave. I asked him who the gentleman was, and he told me that was King Radio. I said, oh, it's another Calypsonian. He said, yes. Anyway, I stay along. I leave and I went back to Sipari to my grandmother. I remain up there and got tired loafing around. Energy is bursting in me and I can't move around. So I met a fan called Alvin Sullivan working in Mr. Tiloxing Theatre. It was a kind of theatre, moving theatre, going from district to district. It is made of tarpaulin covering and like a scout thing. So he moves it from place to place after playing a different district. So my man, that gentleman, I know him by my grandmother, because many times my grandmother give me a penny and tell me to go and buy a penny cigarette for Mr. Sullivan. So I was glad when I saw him. He said, well, we can sleep there in the night. It's all right. So before the time start, opposite to him, I hear a guitar playing, two or three guitars playing. I look and see something like a tent next to a rum shop by Mr. Mentor. So we went in. I say, look, we're going to say we are Calypsonian from Port of Spain. None of them can sing any calypso. I know a few verses that I heard Beginner singing. One morning, I was on a spree one morning. I went to see Dorothy, myself and a policeman, and we met in a collision. So I said, I'll sing that. I said, I have a good voice and I don't know what I will do. So I stood up there. It's a penny to go in. We don't have that penny. So we sit down here. They say, come inside. If you are the Calypsonian, they say. We came in, we went inside. There was a fellow named Puzzler. His right name was, he was a union man too. His name is Musa. Our old man was there, named Inventor, and Young Destroyer was there. He had a beautiful voice, beautiful singer. So we saw, and they singing songs. And so the people start to bawl, where the Port of Spain, man? Come on, Port of Spain. Ah, secret heart of Jesus. Come on, Port of Spain. pull my hat down my face, and I climb up on the stage. And I started singing. One morning, I was on a spree. One morning, I went to see Dorothy. One morning, I met in a collision. It was myself and a policeman. One morning, it is 4 day morning, dancing chorus. One morning, 4 day morning. Well, that was a beginner song that I got a part of. But the voice was sweet and he'll de ball encore, encore, encore. The Calypsonians that were there opened war against me, you know, three of them. I never sing Calypso. Where am I going to sing war? And they start hitting me. My mother's a prostitute, and they're going to take me back and make alpagata. And I just, oh my God. Three of them, I don't know what to answer. You understand? I don't know what to say. I shift myself a little lower down from the tree that I be the last man. Yeah, by that time I might find something to say. But when I reached a little lower down, somebody from behind the bamboo said, tell him that he goes behind Kuli Roti, all about man, that's a dirty man. That's all I catch on him. So when he reached by me, I said, don't talk to me. You know, you always going and nuking for Kuli Roti, and the crowd gone mad. The crowd gone. If Calypso is to take a man to New York, I go in. I want to see New York. Yes, sir. So we took the thing, he gave me a copybook, and he gave me a lead pencil, and he gave me a paper, the papers. He said, look, laborers, water scheme, laborers strike for more pay up at Valencia. Mr. Demonier, the overseer, they ran him with sticks until he reached the police station. They were singing calypsos and carrying, make a cross with stick and run him down. Would you make a song on that? And he handed me the paper, handed me a pencil and a copybook. We took the things and carried on. Lady made some fry bake. They eat. I took a cup of cooked chocolate. They got sleepy. I said, get up now. We have to prove to this man that we are something. So, we put the copybook on the paper, on the table. We're trying. I'm not saying they're not trying, we're all trying. We're trying, but can't cross the channel. They left me and sleeping. I go on until I got, I don't know what to say, water scheme, laborer strike for more pay. I don't know what to say, water scheme, laborer strike for more pay. They began to curse with a reinforcer, singing calypsos and carrying cross. They demonstrated so fearlessly by demanding they wanted more salary. Say, got it? Got it? And I sat down and made four voices. No writing. I got up and touched him. Get up. Yeah, let me see. You see, make it a set. I went up the road to Mr. Moore. And I told him about the song. I said, it's finished. He said, what? I said, it's finished. He said, impossible. Could you sing it? I said, yes. I sing it to him then. I hand him the copy book and the pen. He said, and he led. He said, you didn't write anything? I said, no. He said, boy, you're a genius.
Now, records show that in 1935 is when you're supposed to have made your debut with a tune called Money is King. How accurate is that information?
That isn't accurate.
What is the truth?
You said I made a what?
Your debut in 1935 singing Money is King.
No. I made my debut when I left Chaguanas, because singing that in Chaguanas, I left Chaguanas after my hand got damaged. Then there was an explosion. about Mikey Cipriani and Bradshaw playing Losing El Chicuro Mountain. And they advertised all over Port of Spain that the dead people and them and the people's search party were searching all along. So the cinema and Admiral Khan, the cinema, the owner of the cinema, the Palace Cinema San Fernando, advertised Calypso competition for the best Calypso on the disappearance of Mikey Cipriani and Bradshaw.
What year was that?
1934. Lionel already came back from New York for making record. So I made a song, Go Down to San Fernando there with my friends. I sang it to them and they said, you're good, man. Go in. I said, I'm going to try. Executor, Lion, Attila, Black Prince, and a host at the top. What the man named? Railway Douglas, Rascasa, modern inventor, beginner, well, the cream of the country. Black Prince from Saint-Ouen came down. Now, my advantage there, or disadvantage, was I never sang with a guitar, a quattro before. I mean, a band. This man was playing the music. A good band, Bonus and them, but I never played with a band, and I was under the impression that the band would make so much noise that the people wouldn't get to hear me. So Irene advised me and told me, listen, don't mind the band, don't pay no attention to the band. You sing, the band will follow you. Go ahead. Well, after the whole rounds went, the crowd began to call for executor. He went back and he sang. When the donna said, bring back Tiger, I went back. I sing. The ingeniousness of man has become detrimental in my native land. The ingeniousness of man has become detrimental in my native land. In his aeroplane, Mikey and Bradshaw had mysteriously disappeared the social and yeah. And Al Blanche shares the
toilet
with. Man, the crowd just gone in the air, but I seen jackets in the air, but people standing on the benches, man. Oh my God, people, Tiger, Tiger, Tiger. Anyway, when the competition was declared, radio sang, no more Mikey again. No more Mikey again. You lose your life in your aeroplane. He sang, no more Mikey again. You lost your life in your aeroplane. One morning about 6:30, he went to carry this plane to Baker to deliver some papers. But kiss your wife once again, Mikey, before you go in your aeroplane. And he went. The tie myself and Attila for second. They tied Black Prince and Lion for third. Okay, come out. $10 I got. When my friends were wrong, I gave them that to go around with their business, enjoy themselves. So the next day, 2 days after, I went to the library and I looking up some books. I went by the papers division and look and I saw competition in Port of Spain for the best composition on Mikey Cipriani. And they mentioned San Fernando Tiger will be there. But I was not invited, you know. That is a publicity stunt or whatever they do. I don't know, I came up in town and a fellow named Nanandi. They had a little tent where Royal Theatre is now. Remember, it wasn't carnival time, so they built a temporary business there. I came up, nobody, I haven't seen much people. I saw a beginner, one who I knew. He said, me, why you came up? I said, I saw you advertise San Fernando, Calypsonian. He said, all right, you're there. So I stood up there outside by Royal Theatre and said, you know, I'm a lone star in the woods there. Lion up and down, you have a bicycle mark all over it, lion, 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 lion. Anyway, passes it mark in yellow, lion, lion. I think he hat and all marks lion. So, Coskel, I'm watching. So when his turn came to sing, God, the show was going on good, you know, hot. When his turn came to sing, and they announced the roaring lion, the way the people hail, and boy, you'd be lean, they'll bring down the entire tent. And then they began lampooning me. When lion was gone, they said, ladies and gentlemen, we have a young boy, a young man here. Like we're getting to have a zoo. You just had the roaring lion, who you know. Here comes a fella telling you he's tiger. And tiger with a degrading the baritone tone is how they are. They announce me. So the crowd laughed. I went up and sang. If you drop a pin, you won't hear it. I sang and sang. I sang what I had invented a new verse in the song. When Mrs. Lovell at Toko had mislead the people who are searching for the people, the searchers, she said she saw a plane flying in the air. I more believe that she was looking to get publicity freely, because the way she said was bombing and swinging. And so I add that to this, and to add that piece, a little thing to it. And as Jesus was made to carry the cross, the rudder was placed on the rudder of the plane were placed on the horse, and side by side they were taken to the cemetery to be buried. The cemetery. The crowd, as though they stay and they get wind up from some atomic force, and they bust. Oh God. And Captain Cipriani and Sir Greford and the people, with the man, the music director, and all of them said. The captain said he had no difficulty in coming to the conclusion in this competition as far as concerned. The Growling Tiger from San Fernando has won the competition. Oh my God. A man came out the tent and met me on the pavement by Royal Theatre and told me his name was Lewis, and he owns or partly owned La Cuhab, and he was going to build a tent there, and he would like me to come sing in the tent. He told me, let us go down to Crystal Palace tent as a form of advertisement. And if you sing two songs there, people might want to come to hear you. I said, all right. I went there. He asked the tiller to allow me to sing two songs. I went up and sang the Maribella Wedding. And Money is King. If a man have money today, people don't care if I have cocoa bay. If a man have money today, people do not care if he have cocoa bay. He can commit murder and get up free and live in the governor's company. But if you are poor, the people tell you shoo, and a dog is better than you. If you have money, to buy in a store. The boss will shake your hands at the door. Call the clerks to take on everything. Whiskey cloth, earring and diamond ring. Send them to your home on a motorbike. You can pay the bills whenever you like. And not a soul will ask you a thing. They know very well that money is king. A man with a collar and tie and waistcoat. Ask a Chinaman to trust him, accra and float. Me not trust him, follow the Chinaman. And you better move on from me frying pan. You college man, me no know ABC. If you want a macra, give him penny. The worm start to jump in the man belly and he cry out, a dog is better than me. A dog can walk about and take a bone, fowl head's tail, red fish tail and pone. And if it's a good breed and what to wild, people will take it and mine as a child. When a hungry man goes out to beg, they will set a bulldog behind his leg. Three policemen may arrest him too. You see where a dog is better than you. See? If you have money and thing going nice, any woman would call you honey and spice. If you can't give her a dress and you pair of shoe, she'd say she have no uses for you. When you try to caress her, she'll tell you stop. I can't get love in a Chinese shop. Most of you will agree that it's true. If you have no money, a dog is better than you.
Was there actually a competition in 1935? But the year that you sang Money is King?
No, there wasn't a good commission. The commission I sing Union song. I'm advising every worker as a West Indian to try and join a labor union. I'm advising every worker as a West Indian, try and join a labor union. It's the only way you can achieve your right and to stop the oppressive hands of might. To allow your progressive march to be an inspiration to the rising generation. That was the first one. You can come, I tell you. Well, I win it. Money's came to beat them too, but because I didn't see they had nothing. And I had another song. Workers' Appeal. Anywhere you go, you're bound to meet people sad. There's no employment, you couldn't be had. Anywhere you go, you can't meet people sad, for they can't get employment in Trinidad. Some start to drop down dead in the street. Nothing to eat and nowhere to sleep. I beg you, kind-hearted employers, I appeal now to you. Give us some work to do. I beg you, kind-hearted employers, I appeal now to you, give us some work to do. We're not asking for equality to rich, one with the rich in society. Not asking to own your cigar or to go in your club and smoke your cigar. All we are asking is for a living wage to eat something now and save for old age. I beg you, kind-hearted employers, I appeal now to you, give us some work to do. I'd have been done with that. I'm telling you. Now, in Barbados, Mr. Maurice Jones from Trinidad promoted this West Indian Calypso competition. Small Island Pride from Grenada, Killer from Trinidad, Boy from, Coffee from Guyana, Killer from Trinidad, from Gasparillo, I from San Fernando, Radio from Port of Spain, he from Barbados, the mighty Shama. Got a cup from Gilles from the other, kind of kiss a bear. So I wasn't going to sing any commission, but they arguing that if I told them, listen, man, if you win the cup, give it to Chairman, man, make him a present. He come here every day helping us and thing, go and make message. You understand what I mean? Give him a little kind of help up there. They say, no. I won the cup. I say, well, nobody getting the cup, I'm going to sing. Well, you will really have to sing to beat me for the cup. Don't study Chama. So, Ray just sing a terrible song, you know? The abolition of slavery. Why? When the Danes were throwing the slaves, shackle and chain, overseas on the side British ship, and a lot of different man get it good, you know, masterpiece or something. But I know people, I say, you can't win with that. A nigger man don't like to hear his misfortune. He don't like that at all, especially when he go in status. Don't tell him what he had, he chuckle and chain and all this kind of stupidness, man. He passed that. Anyway, that was good. Chamasa, a woman is my mother's a man, a mother is a man's best friend. That was very moral. The moral, that was very strong. I admit that. Fighter over the man, terror. Sing a good song. They were good. All my small island pride, well, he think he could win with them jump jump song. Taxi, Venezuelan taxi driver, when he push up the oil and the oil busts through. And
bus to the carburetor.
Bus to the carburetor and thing, and he jumping up and jumping up.
Yeah.
When my turn came to sing, I had infanticide. So I sing. I wonder if it's decency or it is hypocrisy that robs a mother of her sympathy. I wonder if it's decency or it is hypocrisy that robs a mother of her sympathy. Anywhere you turn around Port of Spain, you find babies in bull box, paper bags and drain. Such hideous or brutality is contrary to the laws of humanity. Yes, I can remember by the Royal Theatre, a child was found in the dry river. Very fortunate that a man was passing by when he heard a little angel cry. Visible to him was an infant face with tears in its eyes. Oh, what a disgrace. Well, where was the mother and who could she be to violate all the laws of humanity? A child in Taylor Street was found wrapped up in rag, all concealed in a paper bag, receiving in the cold, in the dew and rain, and not a soul around to explain. The paper bag was shifting mysteriously, and it attracted a policeman who was on duty, but he died on his way to the hospital. But you call her a mother or a criminal.
Now, you know, there was a talk in those days about war and extempo. In your opinion, was war and extempo the same thing, or was it something different?
No, it's extempo. Extempo war.
It's one and the same thing?
Yeah.
And you actually sang a tune called War, you remember that?
Yeah, that is... Well, I couldn't get anybody there to sing War. So you put on a piece of war. Mm-hmm. Get up in the morning and I look at the sky. I get up in the morning and I look at the sky. Sometime I just wonder why. When I get up in the morning and I look at the sky, sometime I just wonder why. If it's my planet to sign man destination, or to put God his own hand, to meet the destruction, it is sorrow and affliction with the rising generation. Them from the war, you see? So, and I prepared, that's war chorus.
Yeah. So what used to happen in the tents when they had a war?
Because most of the people there is war, they come to sing war, you know. Well, they began to sing on you, sing on three men at one time. Executor do that too, you know. And,
who were some of the good war singers in your time?
Executor, I think, was about the best, yeah. Attila was very good. Pretender wasn't bad, but can't come up to that standard. Okay, who again? I was singing, who again? Got war in those days, the more you tell the man the facts, the less you could, the easiest you can conquer him. Mm-hmm. I sing war with the executor there, Duncan Street Corner, where they have it, and he was giving me, telling me about they have a type of calypsonian come from Ohio, some come from Los Bajos. All of them come and see the singing calypso. You come from Yokohama with a two-filling Panama.
But I told him that he had a job at a store worker at a store in town. And with all his education and his background, he's caught you for stealing bobbin and thread and trust. Oh my God! He jumped up in the air and he cussed. San Anfaville was there, and Captain Supian and them. He said, your mother tell you come from the country. What do you know about me, man? He said, son, you touch them.
What's that?
Yeah, they're gone. It takes them. But you go and tell them, but you was in hell and you fight the dog. And that don't do anything to them. You ain't doing anything.
Now, it is recorded that the first official Calypso competition was in the year 1939, and you have the distinction of being the first ever monarch. Yeah. Tell us about that.
Well, I tell you part of it there. First to begin, and the fellas don't know what song you're singing. A lot of them say I was singing Money's King. A lot of them say that I'm singing a Plan for Vision and Fix My Affairs, because, you know, what time was, you know, and that type of thing. And they had the call sex office had some kind of talk about it, that I shouldn't say that the white people fight for some 10,000 years. So they talk that one of the song that might have created some. So I came down in my West Indian labor song.
So that's the tune that you actually, the labor, the name of it was the labor situation in Trinidad?
They say so, but I said, you hear what I said? The West Indian
labor
situation.
West Indian labor situation. That's the official title of it.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And that's the year you won in 1939.
Yes, it's 16th of February. And I win in 1950 in Barbados. I win 943 in the Marara.
Were you a person to make road march type tunes?
No, I don't want to prize myself in that, because they were not called road march until Kitchener started to flow that. They were called Legos. Because I sing Take Me to Losiro, and that took the road.
You were the person who composed Take Me, Take Me.
Take me to Losiro, and that was one who...
Up to today, people still sing that. I still sing it on the quattro.
take me to Losiro, and don't let me more, no? And even... this thing that was I met in come from the African thing. We say on your leave me by Gongobara. Gongobara, 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 Gongobara. We say on your leave me by Gongobara. Yeah, by Gongobara, me de leave me by Yana Rona, me on your leave me. I did him by Gongobara. Ding, Gongobara, me tell him by. Then I had witnessed thing, force of shocking thing, is the Marabella wedding.
Yeah, that was one of the two tunes you sang when you came down to Port of Spain.
Yeah.
So tell us about this Marabella wedding.
Well, there is a fellow in San Fernando, I think he died last year, by the name of Eddie Polo. He plays Wewe, and of course he has a reputation as some bad John. Well, bad John, in my opinion, is until you get stopped, you don't bad. Bad until somebody say, well, it's time to go. And he had a wedding in Marabella. He was married. But the morning of the wedding, he was playing card behind the door. The police came and make a raid, and he ran away. They didn't catch him. So while the wedding celebrating were going on, the police come behind the door, and the window. And according to the song, as they were singing so merrily, the bridegroom was unfortunately taken into custody. It may sound to you jocular, but it's a wedding that took place at Marabella. It may sound to you jocula, but it's a wedding that took place at Marabella. The daily papers advanced it to me, and so I gave him my sympathy. And I was singing so merrily, the bridegroom was unfortunately taken into custody. I went out there, but it was told to me, the morning of the wedding he was playing wappy. The policeman then made a raid, he ran away without being persuaded. While speech were made around the table, up comes a constable by the table. Grab him by the table, and as they singing so merrily, the bridegroom was unfortunately taken into custody. If you were there, you were bound to laugh. The veil of the bride had got torn in half. Cakes were thrown east, west, north, and south when the police had the bridegroom and chuck him out. A little boy who was 9 years old struck the policeman with an enamel bowl. So never again to attend no wedding. The Bajan man was saying that. To attend no wedding again. So that was the Marabella wedding.
Now you did a recording in 1979, and some of those tunes people have heard and they are a little bit more familiar with. Like there's a particular tune called a motor car horn. Now tell us something about that particular tune.
My girl Veronica, my girl Veronica, she does make me bawl. With a taxi driver, the guy name is Paul. We live in the country, she walking in the city. 4 o'clock every morning, he blowing the horn for she. Well, I don't mind he talking to she, and she talking to he, papa, yo. I don't mind he takes her to work every morning in the taxi. I don't mind they seeing each other and they carrying on, but what I can't take is the way he does blow the motor car on. 4 o'clock one morning, they wake me from sleeping. I lying on my bed, I tired, I can't raise my head. He came there blowing constantly, so I went out to see. The girl in the back seat was dressed in a bikini. Well, I don't mind he taking her and she talking to him. I don't mind he takes her to work in the morning in the country. I don't mind they seeing each other and they carrying on. But what I can't take is the way that he drive this motor car on.
I saw the neighbors talking and they gossiping about her behavior with the man in that motor car. The rain was falling, it was nice time for romancing. I had her so busy, that night was my jubilee. She said, don't mind a talking to he and he talking to me. I am doing nothing funny, I give you that guarantee. I tell her, keep talking, darling, the memories will linger on. To the day of my death, I will never forget that motor car.